hey guys, welcome to my channel. Dex is here. Today I'm going to share how we can use SQL statement to join different kind of tables. If you have followed my video, you know that we've set up relationship among tables. In our examples, we are still using the same concept to join the table within a query. If you haven't had a chance to look at our example, you can refer back to my video. Or if you would like to look at my demonstration right away, you can download the sample files down below. Today I guys cover two kinds of joins. One is the inner join and another one is the outer join. We'll be looking at the differences within the example. Without further ado, let's get started. So for today, we'll be focusing on joining the students to activity participation records. So for the activity table, we can just close it by now. But after you understand what I'm doing in this video, it will also be quite trivial for you to also extend the relationship, the join, the third table, that is the activities table. As we'll be looking at the differences between the inner join and outer join function, so I like to add a new record on the students, so you have a better idea. Now I add in another student called Chen Taiman. So now it's ready for me to demonstrate on this first query, that is the inner join. As usual, you just go to the create section and then create a new query, skip the design view and then go straight to the SQL view. First thing first, we'll be working on select everything from the students table. And then we do the inner join. Inner join the table of activities participation. The condition would be matching the key fields, right? On students, student ID equals activities participation, student ID. So now here is the select star. What is this star referring to? Referring to the students table or referring to the activities participation or both? So the answer is both. When we are doing the table join, the whole thing would be regarded as a data source of the select statement. For this star, it means we grab all the results from the result of the table being joined. Let's look at the result now. At the left, it will be the master student table. At the right, it will be the records about the students. As you remember, there will be a new student called Chen Taiman, but it haven't got any kind of activity participation yet. So in the inner join, the new student without any kind of activity participation records yet, it will not be shown. In general, only the records that matches both tables will be shown. So this is the characteristic of inner join. How about the outer join? There will be two kinds of outer join. That is the left join and right join. For most of the cases, we'll be using the left outer join. That means putting the master table at the left and then the related record at the right. So this is what the left outer join means. For most of the database system, it is assumed that when we put in left or right, we can skip the outer word. So we just say left join or right join, it will automatically knows that it is an outer join. Let's look at how it goes. The outer join literally means that it will still match the table A and table B, but if the key only matches table A but not the table B, it will still show all the records on the table A. And then for the table B, if there isn't any matching record, it will be empty, or in some database system it will show a null here. This is how the outer join works. How about the right join? To be honest, I seldom use the right join, but it is still doable. For the right join, it is just swap the order between the master table and the related records. I just try to swap it right now. So now I put the master table at the right. The related records are at the left. This is what the right join means when we hit run. Literally, it is doing the same thing, but the logic and the order of the columns are reversed. This is just another way of doing the outer join. Something I haven't mentioned in a previous example is that what if I want to select only some kind of columns? It is pretty simple. Similar to the cases where there is only one table, we can do something on the select statement. For example, if I like to remove student ID from the activity participation table, what I gotta do, I only select the activity ID from the activity participation table. To avoid the ambiguity, we better also mention all the tables that is linked to the column. For example, like now, activity ID should be coming from the activity participation table. Now I gonna explicitly tell the system so that it will know where to look for the columns. Just like the previous example, I just use a comma to link up all the selection. I want all the columns from the students table. Students.star when I hit run. Now you see that I only got the activity ID from the activity participation table and all the columns on the student table. This is how we are picking the columns from the select statement. Next, I'm gonna introduce self-join. Let me do this with the students example. From students, students. I use a comma for this one. When you're doing a self-join, it is important to name the tables, the instances as alias. To defining an alias for the tables is basically the same syntax as defining an alias for a column. We just use the S to define the alias. Let's see how it goes. It's basically mapping all the possible combinations among different kind of records. In this example, it may be useful in the context where we would like to list out all the combinations of students talking to another student. When we are not talking about the students, maybe we're talking about MTR stations. For example, in the island line, maybe we're looking at where Chai Wan can match with Tai Wan, Chai Wan can match with Peng Fa-chun, and Chai Wan can match with Xiao Qiwan. Peng Fa-chun can match with Chai Wan, Peng Fa-chun can match with Xiao Qiwan, and Xiao Qiwan can match with Chai Wan, Peng Fa-chun can match with Peng Fa-chun, and Xiao Qiwan can match with Xiao Qiwan. Okay, so you know what I mean. In a self-join, you can also use the where statement to make more sense out of the query. For a student example, if the student's I'm talking to himself or herself, you can do something like where a.studentID not equals to b.studentID. You eliminate all the records of talking to himself or herself. This is actually how we can work on a self-join in an example. Finally, there are two more kinds of join that I haven't got the chance to demonstrate on the Microsoft Access because unfortunately it is not supported in the Microsoft Access. But these are pretty common in other kinds of commercial database systems. One is natural join. For a natural join, it can be any kind of join, but if you use the natural keyword, that means both table, it will try to automatically match the key that is with the same name on the column so that you don't have to use the on function to define where are the keys. So this is just a handy way for you to quickly set up a table join. This is the natural join. Another kind is the full outer join. For the outer join, you already look at the outer join. All records at table A will be shown, and for the table B, if there isn't any kind of matches, it will show a null. So for the full join, it will show all the records on the table A and table B. So if there isn't a match on the table A, it will show a null on the table A side. If there isn't a match on the table B, we show the null on the table B side. But if you have already set up the entity integrity, the use case would be quite rare for the full outer join in my opinion, but there is such a function in a lot of commercial systems in the database world. And last time, remember that we have already set up a relationship between different kind of tables. So why do we still need to use the on function in this query? The answer is that for a query itself, we still need to define the on function on the key each time we're working on the queries, unless this is natural join where I've mentioned just now. So what's the point of setting up the relationship in the tables, in the schemas anyway? So the answer is that this will be useful for you to set up the relationship with the design wheel in Access, so they will automatically try to map out the keys for you if you have defined at that point. Another way, even if you're working on the SQL all the way, it's still worthwhile for you to set up the relationship because don't forget that there will be some kind of referential integrity kind of things that you'll be taking care of. If you've set up the relationship and you enforce the referential integrity, you're covered on the cascade update and cascade deletes, and then you won't have any kind of records that doesn't have a master record like we mentioned last time. So these are the keywords that we are covered today. I think that's it for today. Thank you very much. I hope that the information here will be useful for you. So if you like this video, hit thumbs up, subscribe, and comment down below. See you soon in the next video.